Hey everyone, welcome back to some more Forza Horizon 4. So last time I did a rally event in this car in the main Forza Horizon world, and yeah, that was everything is fun in this game, man. I love these driving games. Okay, wow, why is the map taking such a long time to load? Oh, wrong button. Makes sense. So today I will be doing a new championship, and let's see what new summer championships we got. So, seasonal objective 249. I've already beaten that, so I can repeat. Retro sports cars. Let's do this. Retro sports cars is what we need. A class. This is what I'm gonna be doing for the video. Oh,
200 meters.
Man, oh, no.
Turn left. Turn left. Turn right.
Retro sports cars, let's do this.
Considering it's spring and we're in the UK, I can't guarantee good weather for this championship. What I can guarantee is that it'll be fun come rain or shine.
What is wrong with this bitch? It's not spring, it's summer. She's like...
You have arrived at your destination.
Go and make a retro sports car of A class so I can like participate in the championship right there. So, give me a moment. Like, it's a retro sports car A class. Cool. So let's see how it goes. Hey. My cars. Retro sports cars. There we go. So we have all of these. Nice. Oh, I have this. I can make turn this into a really good A-class car. Alright, let's do it. We're gonna be taking the gismo GTR LM from Nissan. This car was manufactured back in 1995, the same year I was born in. And so it might end up being one of my favorite cars of all time. Let's go to the custom upgrade section. I'm not gonna be swapping out anything, I believe, like 3.2 i6. I could go with that. Yeah, it's a road championship, so like that gives me a more linear acceleration. So yeah, why not? Let's take that. I won't be installing the twin turbo, the single turbo even. I'll skip that because it's a road championship. If it were an off-road championship, maybe. Okay, we're good here. So let's try all the street upgrades. Let's see where we end up with those. And then we'll see if we want to upgrade it further. So there's the street tire compound. Wider tires, of course. I like those tires, actually. Yeah, I'll go with these. These look good on this car. Since it's a road championship, I'll just use the bigger alloys. And it's gonna be aggressive AF. Now this car is actually looking nice. Like, seriously good. Maybe I'll be able to install all the sports upgrades as well. Like, there's a really good chance I should be able to do that. Sport, race, rally, drift. Stock here. Oh wow. I will be installing all the sports upgrades as well then. Just the tires. Just this tire upgrades are available if I want to make it a street ready car. So that makes no sense. Okay. We're installing all the sports upgrades as well. So nothing here. Let's go with the sport tires. So that's gonna add some grip and better handling. Cool. Let's go with that. Then we got sport clutch, Squat this. Squat that. Squat that shit. Okay. Sport brakes. Okay. Sport spring and dampers. Sport front anti-roll bars. Sport rear anti-roll bars. Sport chassis. Sport weight reduction. EZ. Sport intake. Nothing over here. Sport fuel system. Sport ignition. Sport exhaust. Sport cams and valves. Sport valves. Sport engine block. Sport pistons. Street oil cooling. Okay, sport. And sport flywheel. We're good to go. Perfect. This car is perfect now. Now just to apply a really good vinyl on it and we should be good to go. So let's see. Where are the vinyls? Find new designs. Yay. It's a sports car, okay? It's not, I'm not putting a race vinyl on it. It's a sporty, I want this. So, yeah. If I like upgrade my car to its maximum potential, then putting those kind of vinyls will make sense. But since it's a sports car, I think we should be good. Let's go, game! I have really high expectations from this Nissan since it's legendary. Like, it should perform really well. Otherwise, I'm gonna be extremely disappointed. Ooh, looks badass! Let's do it. Not a very impressive speed, I must say, but...
have arrived at your destination.
Excuse me, what? The acceleration on this car sucks. Man, that doesn't make a lot of sense.
Turn around when it is safe to do so. In 200 meters, turn right. Turn right.
Let's do this! Like, I wanted this car to be more beastly than what it is right now, but it's okay. I think it will have a really good, how should I put this? Overall acceleration, I guess. Speed. Shifting so weird. Doesn't really make sense. But fucked up. I'm sorry. Still have three more laps, two more laps to go, so maybe I can catch up. Why, but this just does not feel like I'm doing it naturally. Like, I don't know why, but this car is not as good as I was expecting it to be. Maybe I had too high expectations. Really does not make any sense. Why? This car's acceleration sucking so much. Like, a little... Okay. But it's fine. Like, there's still... I still have a good chance. If I can, like, nail it from the start. So this is, like, first session. The first video I'm recording for today's session. And I'm playing after, like, a week. So it's okay. Like, this is just the first race. I can still do this. I'll never learn how to change my clothes in this game, like, seriously. Why is that even a thing? Okay, where's the next race now? Over here. Okay, so instead I'll just sit. I'll have to turn around.
In 400 meters, turn right. Turn right. In 400 meters, turn left. Turn left. Arrived at your destination.
I tried to do much better than what I did last time, so it shouldn't be as bad. Like, I don't know why, but this car's shifting is just kind of weird, if it makes sense. I should maybe let the car gain some speed and then shift to second gear. Do a little burnout then. I'm last! Come on, game! Don't be such a shit. This isn't supposed to happen, guys. This isn't supposed to happen. Oh my god, dude, come on. One more lap, I'm still at the 7th place. I'm doing a lot better than last time, but still, I can do much better than what I'm doing right now. Today is just not a good day. What else? Like, there's no other explanation why I'm not able to catch up to these people. Because this is exactly the kind of difficulty that I want to play on. It's not like it's too difficult for me. I am very close to these guys, and if I like start catching up to them, I know I'll like be able to easily take over at least a few of them. Not all of them. So. It's okay, it's fine. But I didn't really do well in this race, in this championship, but it's fine. Like, I don't know. It was a little hard to understand why I was not doing well, but whatever. There's still more races to go to do. So I'll just tune down the difficulty by a bit, if that makes any sense.
In 100 meters, turn left. Thank you.
damn it. I don't know why, but I'm just not able to catch up to these guys. It doesn't really make sense, but okay, whatever. I should have toned down the difficulty a bit. Not happy with my performance. Like, I know, if I tune down the cosmetics, definitely I can do this, but I don't know, it doesn't really make sense to me. Alright, let's solve one of those Fortune Island treasures, and yeah. Treasure number 7. What does it say? 80s Lambo was built for it's the LM002. Let's nail this objective then.
In 200 meters, turn left. Turn left. In 400 meters, turn right. Turn right. In 400 meters, turn right. Turn right.
Done with that! Okay, so we need the LM002 Lamborghini from the 80s off-roading. It can, like, no other Lamborghini would be from the 80s and good for off-roading. I'm pretty sure about that. So it's gotta be the LM002. See, it's 1986. This is the one. And I already own it. Wow. Can't exact Lamborghini. There we go. Alright, let me just go to the upgrades and tuning section and just upgrade it. Max upgrade it out. So let's start with this. Racing, engine, rear wheel, all wheel. I'll stick with the all wheel drive over here. Along with twin turbo, because definitely going to go for an off-road thing. Race front bumper, race rear wing. This Lambo is gonna get upgraded. Major. It's an S1 class now, and yeah, we're good to go. Okay, so let's see. Blaze through the forest without getting hurt. God damn it! Let me just move out of this place. Old Arch Forest, Westwick Launch, Lakeside. Blaze through the forest, ruins leap. Like, Old Arch Forest. We need to do this. So I'm gonna go over here first and then follow this road through there. And we should be good to go. Yep.
At your destination.
What? Lace through the forest. Is there any other forest? Nope. Southland, Viking Bay, Skildar Watch, Lady on the Lake, Lakeside. Ruinsleep. What? How is this not it? View of the ash tree. Without getting hurt.
This 80s Lambo was built for dirt. Blaze through the forest without getting hurt.
Doesn't really make sense. Game. Blaze through the forest without getting hurt. This is the only thing that says forest. Halcyon Point. Forest run.
Turn right. In 400 meters, turn right. Turn right. Arrived at your destination.
Champ. Location updated. Better hurry, you know. You've made some of the other treasure hunters on this island pretty desperate.
Where's the treasure?
Around when it is safe to do so. Recalculating route. In 200 meters,
Turn right. Arrived at your destination.
This is the place. This is weird. This was the place right here. There it is. Easy!
Another one! Congratulations, I suppose. We've tried our best to keep your identity secret from other Horizon drivers, but I wouldn't go flashing that cash around the festival if I were you.
Let's head back home then. Maybe do a cross-country thing? Since we're in the car anyways. Let's do that exhibition event right there. I'm in the mood too, like, I was very happy with the performance in the
turn left.
Nissan gismo, so might as well do a few, one more event at least. This video is very short right now.
You have arrived at your destination.
Westwick Cross Country Circuit, let's do this. Excuse me, what? I can't take... Okay, fine, whatever. Right, so unfortunately guys, this is where I'll be ending the video. In the next one, I'm gonna continue my journey of Forza Horizon 4, and yeah, I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.